So you're based in beautiful Brisbane. Are you in Brisbane or are you in Sydney?
Yeah, John, I'm based in Brisbane, which is in Queensland. Yeah.
Well, I'm sure Adolfo is going to be talking about that. But tell us a little something about yourself. How long have you worked for Carnival?
So I've worked for Carnival for over 7 years now, and thoroughly enjoyed it. It's a fantastic company to work for. Love the cruise, love the product that we offer as well. It's just, it's so great. And to be able to have it here in our home port, not just in Brisbane, but in Australia in general, it's just a very, very unique experience to be able to get out here and do it. But I've been in the travel industry for many, many years, and I just adore it. It's just a great industry.
Wonderful. Weren't you a travel agent too, Mark?
Yes, I was, Adolfo. Yes, I was a travel agent for a few years. I've been a travel agent in the UK, actually, John, as well. So for a couple of years, I was a travel agent in the UK and then again in Australia. So
wonderful. Sorry, Adolfo, I was...
Okay. I appreciate you helping out there. As I was fumbling through my my technology, which we had all practiced in our practice session, and all worked great. So today's From Adolfo's Desk Live is really centered on Australia, and even more importantly, Brisbane. Carnival has been sailing out of Australia for about 8 years now, and we've mostly focused on Sydney departures as well as some Melbourne departures. And then we decided that we were going to home port the Carnival Spirit in Brisbane. And, you know, being an American, many of you are up American or Canadian. When you think of Australia, typically you think of Sydney more than likely. You think of the Opera House, the bridge there, and just that spectacular view that you get from that part of the world. Brisbane is also a very important city in Australia. And I think one of the things that makes it really important for our travel advisor partners out there is that Brisbane is really one of the great gateways to Australia's Great Barrier Reef, which is on everybody's bucket list. So when you're talking about Brisbane, try to put it into the context of the Great Barrier Reef, because that is something that resonates with probably everybody in the US, Canada, and everywhere around the world. So that's what our point is today. We really wanted to talk about our Brisbane departures, the type of itineraries. Mark, as I said earlier, is from Brisbane, and he's actually in Brisbane now. And I think he was saying it's already like 3 weeks from today in the US at 6 a.m. And he's going to walk us through, because he loves the city where he lives and works. And he's got so much knowledge about not only Brisbane, but obviously the great itineraries that we offer on board the Carnival Spirit when she starts sailing out of Brisbane, hopefully sooner than later. So we're going to talk a little bit about Brisbane being the river city, around Brisbane, what to do, because obviously when Americans go all the way to Australia, they're going to want to spend more than 7 days there. And there's obvious opportunities for you to add things before or after the cruise. Mark's going to talk about some great places there that that are really accessible right from Brisbane, and great locations. You'll see this really cool hotel. I've never seen anything like it. There's great unique ports, not only a Great Barrier Reef, but also the South Pacific, which also resonates, I think, with the Americans. Onboard experiences, they're slightly different in Australia. The booking process, we'll just walk you through a couple of the screens just so you can see how to access it. And then obviously commission opportunities and extra earnings that you have. So Mark, why don't you tell us a little bit about Australia's home ports? You can start out with Sydney because it is important to us as well. But obviously we're going to focus today on Brisbane.
Thanks, Adolfo. Look, Sydney is a very well-known port, as you mentioned before, and we have the amazing Carnival Splendor imported out of there. Carnival Splendor arrived in December last year, and starting out of the iconic Sydney Harbour is a great bucket list destination. It's a really great port to be able to cruise in and out of. And the second port we have in Australia is Brisbane. And of course, as you mentioned before, you know, I'm very proud of Brisbane. It's my hometown. I've grown up here, and it really is a fantastic gateway into the South. Again, also the Great Barrier Reef as well, because of its location. It's a very nice temperature place, and we'll cover a few of those things, and we'll cover a little bit more about what the actual port, what the destination looks like. But sailing from Brisbane is the beautiful Carnival Spirit, which I'm sure a lot of you are very familiar with. over the years. And look, Brisbane is, we're very lucky. We've just had a brand new international cruise terminal built. But one thing I wanted to highlight, and I think this is really important, is that where Brisbane, where the cruise terminal is, that little red dot that you can see on your screen, it's very, very close to the airport. So if you do happen to have to transit through either Sydney or Melbourne, one of those destinations, it's very accessible and easy to be able to get out to.
And how long of a flight is it from Sydney to Brisbane?
Yeah, so Brisbane to Sydney is about, or vice versa, is about an hour and a half, kind of an hour 40. And then from Melbourne, it's about just under 2 hours. So it's very accessible and easy.
Okay, great. And John, have you been to Australia, and have you been on one of our ships sailing out of Australia?
So I've been to Australia. Unfortunately, not to cruise. I was supposed to go this year, but that didn't happen. I have a group booked to cruise with me in this year, hopefully towards the end of this year, from Brisbane. Some of my Facebook readers are asking me to go and cruise. They've got a group together of about 200 people. So I'm hoping to get out there. I've never been to Brisbane. I did Sydney. I did all the touristy stuff. The Great Barrier Reef, though, and I made sure I was there during Shark Week on National Geographic, because all the sharks are on television. So if you go that week, there's no sharks.
Oh, okay. That's good. Everybody wants the sharks.
Tell you.
There's another shark. Go ahead, John. Sorry.
There's the terminal. It's. I can't wait to see it. Mark, back to you.
Yeah, so this is the this is a multi-million dollar terminal. It's probably, I'd have to say, it's probably the newest terminal in the cruise terminal in the world at the moment. It was scheduled to open in October. It's been a lot of money and a long time coming. Carnival in general has worked very hard to be able to be a backbone to get this terminal off the ground. And as a result, we actually have grandfather rights here, which is incredibly exciting to be able to have that. It's $177 million terminal, cutting edge from door to onto the ship. It's going to be fantastic.
So what are the grandfather rights? What does that mean?
It means his grandfather owns it.
Yeah, my grandfather owns it. And my great-grandfather. Yeah. No, so basically it gives us first bite of the cherry when we want to look at what scheduling we want to do. So what days we're looking at, what itineraries we're trying to do, things like that. It helps very much with our tracking in order to be able to provide, you know, the best experiences for our guests over the key periods as well. So if Christmas falls on a particular day and we don't want to embark or disembark on that particular day, we have the option to be able to, you know, work our itinerary around that, which is really exciting.
Wonderful.
Okay. All right. So tell us a little bit about your home city, because I've seen some of these photographs obviously already. Some of the shots that you shared with us are pretty amazing. So tell us a little bit about Brisbane and what is the River City?
So Brisbane, a lot of people think of Brisbane, they think of the name, it's Brisbane. Okay, so we get that a lot. That's a lot of fun, particularly from the American market. However, it is pronounced Brisbane. And we are a very smaller city compared to some of our sister cities like Sydney and Melbourne. They're very cosmopolitan and, you know, a lot going on and very well known on the global scale. However, Brisbane's not that well known. A lot of people, when they come to Australia, as John said before, you know, and Adolfo, when you came as well, you end up in Sydney, fantastic city. But Brisbane is really kind of like a local city. So you get to immerse yourself in a really nice local experience and a little bit more of a novelty as well when the Americans come over and join us and the British. The fact that, you know, it's not as big of a tourist destination, but more of a local kind of hotspot. It's a nice insight into the real nice Australian culture as well, and how we operate as a nation.
Hey, John, let me ask you a question. Which accent do you prefer, American accents or Australian accents?
Well, yeah, that's a difficult question because, of course, most Australians can trace their ancestry back to us here, apart from, of course, the the Aborigines, but I personally prefer the Australian accent to the American accent, unless it's the Southern American accent or the New York accent. I just don't like the accent from Ohio. That's the only one. I'm joking. But let me ask you a question, because I'm intrigued by this, because Australia is such a stunning, I mean, all of God's finest creations, plus the ones that he was really annoyed at, he put those in Australia as well. There's great rivalry between, you know, New York and other states, and there's great rivalry between places in England. Is there a rivalry then between Sydney and Brisbane?
John, funny you mentioned that, because there is a very, very big rivalry between Queensland and New South Wales. So Queensland is the state and Brisbane's the capital, and New South Wales and Sydney. We have every year we have a big football game where we play three games, and we play for a trophy basically. And that game was last night. The third and final game was last night. Yes, the state of origin. And I'm very, very proud to say, Queensland, we won last night. So that rivalry, I get to rub that into my colleagues this morning.
That's a reason to book a Brisbane cruise.
Yeah, we're going to confuse all the agents watching this, because they're thinking we're talking about soccer, but it's not even soccer. This is Australian rules. I can't even begin to explain that. It's basically fighting with a ball.
if
the Americans then and the Canadians and even us from the UK, we fly in say 2 or 3 days before the cruise from Brisbane, what's the things to do? Where should we see? What should we do?
Actually, that's great heads on that. Yeah.
Yeah, so look, I mean, we one of the things, you know, like the things to do around Brisbane in particular, there's a lot of experience. You can come and stay in the city and go out. There's a lot of kind of cool places that are surround the city as well, which we can cover off in a little bit. But one of the unique things that I love about my city is in that real heart of the city is this picture right here that you can see, and this is what we call Streets Beach. Streets is an ice cream manufacturer, but they sponsor the beach. But basically, the beach is in the heart of the city. It's a beautiful, you know, white sand, you know, lagoon, purpose-built man-made lagoon, but it overlooks the entire CBD of Brisbane. And there's some great dining experiences around there as well, from, you know, rooftop dining to very al fresco type outdoor dining. We're very much of an outdoorsy kind of city. The temperatures vary. Don't get very cold in the winter. I think we get to about kind of 62 to 64 degrees Fahrenheit during the winter. And in the summer, it's a little bit more humid. So just kind of going around the city, whether it's on one of our city cats, which is one of the little boats that take you up and down the river, embarking in the CBD's beach right here as well, which is Streets Beach. And then a lot of external stuff as well that we have around the city. It's a really great little location to be able to hang out and check out.
I was really impressed with your skyline. I didn't realize it was so big. And I was going to say that, you know, we are, as Americans, when you look at your map, the further north you go, obviously the warmer it gets, where it's the opposite here in the U.S. because everything is kind of backwards there when it comes to seasons. So the fact that it's further north means it's actually a warmer, more tropical climate than it would be further down in Sydney and even further south, right?
Yeah, that's right. And because we're a tropical kind of climate, is that it's funny when you mentioned that. I haven't thought of that before with the US as well. So yes, that's correct. The further north you go, the hotter it does get. And as you head up towards the Great Barrier Reef, which is the northern, even more northern part of Australia, it gets even, the weather gets kind of tropic and nice there as well. We don't rain a lot in the winter. Like winter's very dry for us. So if you are cruising, you get these, you know, those images that you saw before, there's that beautiful crisp blue sky days. That's a very common kind of winter scenario, winter skyline that you'll see with the city backdrop of the city. So.
All right. So tell us a little bit about this light, because this is a pretty stunning photograph too.
This is probably one of my favorite places on earth, I'd have to say, Moreton Island. Moreton Island is just off the coast of Brisbane. We're lucky, we're surrounded by four of the world's largest sand islands in the world. Some of you may be familiar with Fraser Island. That's a very well-known, it's the largest sand island in the world. And the second largest is Moreton Island. And Moreton is so fantastic because it's very accessible to Brisbane. So if you want to do a day trip, it's only about a 45 to an hour minute launch transfer from the city. And then you're basically out of this beautiful sand island. And there's so much to do out there, from ATV riding to four-wheel drive tours. We have this thing called sandboarding. I don't know if you've ever experienced that before as well, where you're lying like a big board and you fly down the sand.
Yes, I've done it.
Yeah,
it was terrifying.
Yeah, I've done it. Look at me and you sandboarding. Yeah, keep going.
You also get a what do you call it? Like a facial on the way down as a sand blasts your face.
It's beautiful. Look at that. So do Mark? Oh my! Yes. Now that was that one. That's yeah. Go back the next one.
Which here. One? This one.
It's the crocodile hunter.
Oh, that one's after this one.
Oh,
I went to.
Yeah.
But this is a really cool experience that I had never heard of before.
Where is that?
So this is still a tango. This is still in Moreton Island. And one of the really unique things we have there, we have a wild dolphin feeding program over there. And about it is that it is really a true wild dolphin experience. Of an evening, there's a big pod of about 50 dolphins that will take turns at kind of coming in. But the key thing to highlight is this is not a... It's not an enclosure. These are wild dolphins. They're given about 8% of their daily diet, so that they're not reliant on the food that's given by the tourists or the day trippers coming across to the island to come in and visit them. And they come down at about in the evening. It's an absolutely phenomenal experience to wade into the water and to see some of these dolphins. We just had we have a dolphin there called Naru, which is just gave birth about kind of a month and a half ago, and her little, I don't know what a baby dolphin's called, but her little baby dolphin's kind of coming in and hanging around Moreton as well, which is really exciting at the moment. So
you have to see those, ladies and gentlemen, going all that way and look at that. That would give you a real porpoise in life.
That's a point, John. Intended, I'm sure. So here we go with the one you wanted to see, John.
Yes.
So Mark, tell us about this.
So a lot of you will be familiar with him. John recognized him instantly, of course, the late great Steve Irwin, the crocodile hunter. Look, his zoo is basically just, it's about a 45 to an hour minute drive from the CBD city. So it's a fantastic place to head up there and, you know, it's an experience that you don't get anywhere else, to be able to go up there and see the crocodiles and interact with the zoo. And, you know, Steve left an everlasting legacy here in Queensland, his hometown. And, I mean, Bindi and Robert and Terry are still all around the zoo. They still hang around. So that's a really great kind of experience to go and check out.
You never know there was so much to do there, right? I mean,
yeah. It's amazing. I have to get there with this group, and I would. I think the first place I would go would be his zoo, because I was a huge fan of Steve's, and I got to actually got to meet him once, just for 45 seconds and shake his hand, and he was really, really a wonderful man, and did he the passion that he had for all things animal and mammal and fish and bird, and extraordinary. And he left us too early, but I didn't realize his zoo was so close to, and saying calling it a zoo is
yeah, it's not really a zoo.
So yeah, definitely have to get down there. Well, we're going to have a busy few pre-day cruises, aren't we? We're going
to be, it's a lot to do. You can even take a selfie with a kangaroo.
Yeah.
So, Mark, this is the Spirit in
in Mooloolaba. So that's a fun name to sell you, Mooloolaba. So Brisbane has two beautiful beaches, north and south of it, one being the Sunshine Coast, which is up where Steve Irwin Zoo is. And this is, you know, this is more of a local kind of beach where a lot of the locals will head up to. It's some great restaurants, beautiful white sand beaches, and are truly spectacular. This was when Carnival Spirit came into Mooloolaba on one of her Sydney itineraries. She comes up to Queensland on a short little four-night cruise. So beautiful. And she's swimming between the flags.
Were you aware that we're going to be giving away a cruise to Australia on this webinar if they stay to the end?
Wow, that's phenomenal. So what a great prize. That's what thanks for the end.
You're going to have to give out your email address, Mark, so that they know exactly what it is that they should do when they go to Australia.
100%, Adolfo. Look, if anyone needs to contact me or wants any information, please by all means do. I do, like I said, I'm very passionate about the city and the destinations. I'm more than happy to give you recommendations, particularly local ones as well. This is the Gold Coast. So south, you've got a beautiful city called the Gold Coast, and the Gold Coast is kind of like a bit like a hybrid mix between Hollywood and Vegas for Queensland. So you've got a great destination where you can go in and you can hang on the beaches and things like that. It's phenomenal.
So what's this photograph? This is Great Barrier Reef, right? Or part of it, a very small part of it.
Yeah, so look, the Great Barrier Reef, a lot of people, this is obviously, you know, the showcase piece of Queensland is the Great Barrier Reef, one of the seven wonders of the natural world. It's 14,000 square miles long. And 133,000 square miles in actual area. So a lot of people don't realize how expansive and how long it is, but it's a phenomenal, if you do want to add extensions pre or post cruises, it's a great opportunity to be able to come up here and check this out.
And how do our guests, when they go on a cruise that goes to the Great Barrier Reef, it kind of describe that experience on how that works?
Yes. When you're cruising up to the, a lot of people don't realize we don't cruise through the reef, okay? A bit of conservation area. In order to go out to the reef, you do a lot of your short tours and things like that to be able to head out there. But the cruise up there, because the reef's so expansive, the waters between the coast and the reef, the cruise on the inside is very calm and easy to be able to kind of come up there as well.
Can I ask, as you're cruising towards the Great Barrier Reef, and is it Alaska? You like to see lots of wildlife from the ship itself, be standing on the Lido or on your balcony?
You'll generally see, John, like you'll see your normal kind of marine animals, like depending what particular time of year, if it's, you know, over the winter months, you'll see a lot of whale activity. We have a very large migration of the humpback whales. So you'll generally see a lot of whales, pods of dolphins, things like that. But that's probably pretty much it. You don't really see turtles too much and things like that. Just mainly those bigger animals that you can see from the decks.
Stunning.
Yeah. So this is the hotel I was alluding to earlier. This is a very special hotel. Tell us about this.
This is a really unique experience, Adolfo and John. You know, this is a hotel called Reef World, and basically there's two accommodation options that you can stay out at. And this is a floating pontoon that floats right near the reef. So you can see there from the window, you have these underwater rooms that look out into the ocean, and you can see the fish pass. While you're having a swim, while you're having a sleep, you can see the fish swimming around beside you. Unique experience. And then the picture below that's a swag. So we have a Australian kind of way of sleeping when you're out in the bush or out in the jungle kind of thing, whatever you call it, is a swag. We roll a bedroll out and you sleep in it. It's a bit more luxurious, but you're sleeping on the deck of what's called Reef World. And this is accessible by Ellie Beach, which is a great port part of the reef.
Yeah, that looks like a really cool experience.
I can just picture myself in that hotel bed. Yes, looking out the window and seeing Adolfo swim past.
Great. Hey, John, can you pronounce that word up on top? Can you pronounce the word up on top, the city with the black little thing next to it? Can you see it?
Can't see it. It's too small. What does it say?
I'll spell it C-A-I-R-N-S. Because it doesn't sound like the way, when Mark says it, it doesn't sound the way it's spelled.
Cairns.
Mark, what is it?
Yeah, it's Cairns. So Cairns is the city. So that's one of the gateways to the reef, of course, if you want to pre or post your cruise. We do, of course, cruise up there as well. But that's another option if you want to add on at the end or before your cruise as well to head back up and spend a bit more time up at the reef, the Great Barrier Reef.
And then this was a little bit of local flair where you said that you know, when you were a travel agent, you always wanted to know where to stay, what hotels, and you had a couple of suggestions here.
Yeah, of course. So look, one of the biggest things is a lot of times you, as a travel agent, you pick up a map of a city and you see hotels dotted all over the city and you don't really get a indication of the best place to stay. So I want to kind of just point out the two main areas. Don't ever stay out of cruise port, okay? There's nothing out there. The cruise terminal is about 4 miles away. So it's about probably $30 to $40 taxi fare or Uber out there. It's not very far. But the main places to stay, where those number two and number three are, that's what we call South Bank. And that's where that beautiful Streets Beach was that you saw before. It's probably my number one pick to stay in Brisbane. And then just behind that, I think it's number 10, where the name Brisbane is, that's the Brisbane City. And that's kind of like the CBD of Brisbane. So if you want to go out nightclubbing or if you want to go, you know, if you want to go late night clubs and things like that, that's the place to stay. So if you're talking to a group of mates traveling or some families, couples that want to go out and experience the nightlife of Brisbane, that's where you want to stay. Anywhere else, that's the two main places to stay.
Okay.
Which hotel does your grandfather own?
All of them, I wish.
So you guys both drive on the wrong side of the road. So you wanted to make sure that Americans understood and Canadians that when they go to Australia, they have to drive on the wrong side of the road, like you do in the UK, John.
Yeah, that's another one of our things that we've passed over to our Australian friends. I should point out that we're having fun, but at the end of the day, we have an incredible relationship, and there's nothing Australians wouldn't do for the British, and there's nothing the British wouldn't do for the Australians, and that's what happens. We do nothing for each other. So it's an incredible place, and I think I'm just going to let Mark talk about this because I got a couple of things. Actually, I'm going to read one now because a few of my Facebook readers wrote to me today about some of their, and these are Americans writing this, and I want to see if Mark agrees and feels like this is fair, because I asked them to sum up their Australian cruising with Carnival and what they feel as the experience was like. And here is a couple of highlights. I'm from Freehold, New Jersey, and we sailed out of Sydney. The Australians were amazing, and it was amazing how they can laugh at themselves, have fun, make friends, and drink all they can drink. But never been on another cruise more than this one where I felt so welcomed by people who were not from America like me. It was the most incredible experience, and I can't wait to get back. And one quick one. I'm from Anaheim, California. I took one out of Sydney last year. The Aussies are wonderful, friendly people who simply love to have a good time. Sailing out of Sydney is a life experience and should be on every Carnival Cruises bucket list. And I will be joining you, John, in Brisbane when I can. So does that sound familiar?
That sounds great.
Lovely words. Thank you. And I mean, we like our respect for the US as well, the Americans. We just get along well. Yes, we joke around a lot and we have a lot of fun. But you're right, we do love a drink. And a lot of our relationships and friendships are forged, you know, over a good, nice, cold Aussie beer, but we don't drink Foster's, all right? So that's something that you think we drink. We don't drink Foster's beer at all here in Australia.
So what's better, John, Vegemite or Marmite?
Now, that's a really good question. Now, for the viewers who do not know either, think of the worst tasting thing you have ever put in your mouth, and now times that by 375,000, and you have discovered Vegemite.
I like them both, actually.
You don't, Adolfo. Now, Adolfo, you're
right back.
Right?
Oh, he's good. Look, I think the problem with a lot of people, John, is that they stick a spoon into a tub of Vegemite and they stick it in their mouth. You don't get any. No Australian on the planet will do that. Vegemite has to be. There it is. Oh, that's Marmite. Vegemite has to be put on toast. You have to put it on toast or on bread. You can't put a spoon of Vegemite in your mouth.
And we digress. So the Marmite Vegemite war continues. Yes. All right, so we're talking about some of the destinations now, Mark, because we're going to run out of time because we have a lot of slides. So we obviously talked a little bit about the Great Barrier Reef. This is another amazing shot. And obviously for scuba divers, I'm sure, and snorkelers and people that just want to see one of the seven natural wonders of the world. Amazing destination. And like I said, when you're talking to your American clients or your Canadians, Canadians might know more about Brisbane than Americans, but, you know, put it into context for them. This is what we're trying to do, is put it into context, what access you really get to, and it being really a gateway to the Great Barrier Reef. That's kind of a snag that you can have when you're talking to your clients about it. So tell us a little bit about this, this 8-day cruise. Or is it 7 days?
This is, 7 days. So this is, we depart, generally on our 7-day cruises from Brisbane, we do a Sunday to Sunday departure, which makes it incredibly cool. So the first day we spend, we do a sea day, one of our fun days at sea. And then our first port of call is the beautiful Airlie Beach. And Airlie Beach is the first of the entry points into the Great Barrier Reef. There's a mass archipelago of a lot of islands, beautiful sand islands that are scattered all around Airlie Beach. But this is a great opportunity to be able to head out to the reef, do a day trip out there, go and experience it and see what it's about. Or there's a lot of unique beach experiences that you can do, and I'll cover off one of them in a sec. And then the next day we head up to Cairns, and we actually overnight in Cairns. Very rare in Australia that we do an extended port stay in a lot of ports. It's not a common thing like it is in the Caribbean, for example. Due to a lot of our port infrastructure here in Australia is undeveloped, and you'll see that in the South Pacific. It's very much like the Caribbean probably was, you know, 40 years ago. So doing water shuttle transfers in nighttime, we try and avoid that, try and do it in the late afternoon. But you get an opportunity to overnight in Cairns, because we're alongside the city of Cairns, and we spend two full days there. So if you want to go and do a night tour of the reef or 2 days of the reef, it's a really unique experience to be able to get out there. Then we do a little scenic cruise around Willis Island, which is basically you don't get off the ship, we just drop anchor, and then we come back, and then we cruise back to Brisbane. So it's a fantastic itinerary.
Yeah, and you know, combining this, especially for long haul guests, coming from the U.S. or Canada, combining a 7-day cruise with some of those amazing spots that you talked about, it really makes a great vacation. It really gives the travel advisor an opportunity to put together a much more, I guess, I don't want to say expensive, but more a higher ticket price package for their clients, so that they have the ability to earn even more commission. So here's some underwater shots, I'm assuming, on the Great Barrier Reef. It looks like an aquarium. And this is a photo you took, right?
This is a rare photo that you get to see Nemo and Nori and Dory from Finding Nemo. Of course, Dory's a surgeon fish and a clown fish there. That's a recent photo. And then the next photo as well, you'll see this was one of me. I was actually up at the Great Barrier Reef just last month on my own holiday. And this is one of my I'm an avid diver. And this is one of my dive photos. And this is what it's like. I just took that photo because it's literally like swimming in an aquarium. It is incredible. Yes. When you're in and diving.
Look at this. Do you see the photo?
Yep. And then this is, if you don't want to go out, the great thing about Cairns is it offers a Great Barrier Reef as well. It offers a great kind of a diverse environment as well. So you don't want to head out to the reef. You don't want to go out and go and sort of the fishes and things like that. You can head out to some of the beautiful tropical forests. And this is the Daintree National Park, which is only about an hour and a bit's drive from Cairns. And you can head out there. It's where the the rainforest meets the ocean, and you get these magnificent white sands, spectacular crocodiles up there in the wild, cassowaries. You've got some crazy animals up there that you can go and check out as well. So those people that don't want to go out to the reef, there's a lot of options for them to be able to head out to.
Very cool. All right, so obviously Carnival Spirit. And then tell them a little bit. This is our weekend sampler, right?
Yeah, we do have weekend samplers as well. They're little 3-day cruises that head out to islands. But we've got Airlie Beach. We do a little great little 4-day itinerary. And this is basically, it's one sea day. You stop at Airlie Beach and one sea day coming home. So you get another opportunity to go and have to check that out. And a lot of people sometimes add this on to the end of like a 7-day South Pacific itinerary. They'll do the 7-day South Pacific itinerary. Cruise gets back in on a Sunday. The 4-day leaves again on a Sunday, comes back on the Thursday. So you kind of get to match those two. If you're shorter on time, you've only got, say, 10 days, 11 days on the ground. Great to be able to head up to Airlie Beach. And if you go to the next picture there, you'll see one of the most beautiful beaches in the entire world is Whitehaven Beach. This is a photo I actually took on my last trip up there last month as well. The sand is 98% silica. So it's the whitest of white sands that you can ever, it's like talcum powder. It's incredible to be able to.
I didn't realize that the towel animals originated in Australia. They're natural there. They're wild animals there, I see.
Yeah, but those ones are poisonous, Adolfo.
Those are what?
Those are poisonous ones.
Oh, okay.
Can you, Mark, do a back-to-back? So if one of our travel advisors has a client that wants to go all that way to do an incredible cruise, but would like to do a back-to-back, will a 7 go into one of the shorter cruises or vice versa?
Yeah, John. So you got two options. You can do a seven day South Pacific, depending on the time of the year, of course, not all the time, but if you run the itinerary correctly, a 7-day South Pacific can go off the back of a 7-day Cape Barrier Reef cruise and vice versa. Or you can do a 7-day South Pacific onto sometimes a 4-day Airlie Beach.
Popular back-to-back cruises are with North Americans and with our American guests who, you know, to fly that way to do 2 or 3 days pre-cruise and then do a back-to-back. I think they would absolutely love that.
Yeah. And the other thing too, I want to stress, and I've said this before, we had another Australia webinar a while ago where you all got to meet Anton and Jennifer. And one of the things that, you know, I want to make sure that we get clear out there is that the Carnival guest, you know, oftentimes I think we get pigeonholed into the Caribbean, 3-4 day, 7 day cruises, Eastern, Western Caribbean. You know, we obviously have a lot of deployment that does that, but whenever we do these European cruises, obviously Alaska, the Hawaii cruises, when we did, John, and you'll probably remember this, when we did the Splendor circumnavigation around South America, that we had over 1,000 guests that were on all three segments, 45 days. So just because they're a Carnival guest does not mean that they're not willing to take longer vacations, more exotic destinations like Australia, South Pacific. So just remember, keep us in mind. Don't write us off because our guest, and John knows more than anyone because he's been on a lot of these special cruises where these guests want something different, want something longer and more exotic. So,
yeah, and the back is something that I'll help promote because I think those seeing the different places, you're going all that way and just to do a 7-day cruise, if you can add on an extra 3 or 4 days, I think that's wonderful. And there's the map.
That's the South Pacific, right? Mark?
Yeah, that's right. That's the South Pacific. It's right on our doorstep and it's incredibly close from Brisbane. It's 1 day closer from Brisbane than it is from Sydney. Which allows us to be able to do a really nice extensive 7-day itinerary to the South Pacific. And as I mentioned before, South Pacific is really like what I envisioned the Caribbean would have been like 40 years ago. Not a lot of infrastructure out there. But however, some of the islands we go to and we visit, you know, the locals come across from another island and set up shop there and look after our guests while we're there as well. So very beachy, beautiful areas. This is Ubia, which is Basically, it's a very French-inspired area. It's a colony of France. They actually spend Central Pacific francs there as well. But the whole of the New Caledonia area is a World Heritage listed marine area as well. So you've got the most exquisite, beautiful white sand and that turquoisey, amazing waters that you see diving and snorkeling is magnificent.
Yeah, those photographs are breathtaking. This is beautiful too.
That's Lifu. Lifu is absolutely amazing. If you want to flick through the slides while we're going, Adolfo, so that's an amazing port. Lot of snorkeling and cultural experiences you can do. I love to be able to just do some of the Melanesian cultural tour. This is Marae, it's pronounced Marae. This is a magnificent little island. It's about 5,000 people. Isle of Pines, this is the jewel of the Pacific. It is where the beautiful pine trees meet the turquoisey waters, and it is one of the most beautiful spots. I think the background, your background behind you, Adolfo, is Carnival in port there.
Okay. Yeah, look at these photographs. I mean, I can see one of our tenders there. It looks like one of our tenders.
And this is Mystery Island. Mystery Island's not a mystery. It's actually called an island. Nobody lives on it. It's one of the real exclusive spots that we head out to. It's in the country of Vanuatu. And it is magnificent. Top tip, if you see where the pier is on the north of the photo, if you just kind of cross to the other side of the island there, it's a short little walk, 2 or 3 minutes. That is a beautiful lagoon to go swim. And you can walk around the island in about an hour. So it's a really neat experience.
That's beautiful. And this is obviously not Australia, or is it?
No, it's very rare we've got a photo of two Carnival ships in the same photo. So this is one of your magnificent ports. But I wanted to highlight this, as John mentioned before, doing a back-to-back is a great way. You come all the way over to Australia, you can do some really nice kind of 14-day itineraries and do a back-to-back with Great Barrier Reef, tack onto a South Pacific, or put your South Pacific before that as well. So if you check out gocccl.com, you'll find all the sailing dates. This is one for next year, which is 22 August, and then 29 August on to the South Pacific. Great way to add up and get your guests to experience the two fantastic kind of destinations that we offer down here in Australia.
Yeah,
I was talking to your colleagues in Australia last week, and they sent me a date. So yes, Carnival with a touch of Aussie. So what does that mean?
So what that means is, look, it's the same Carnival service and the fun and the onboard experience that you have. However, we've customized it for the Australian kind of market, where you feel like you're still on an international cruise. You don't just feel like you, say, for example, in the Caribbean. You do feel like you're in Australia. You've got surrounded by Australian guests. You've got Australian local beer and wine on board. You've got some fantastic experiences like that as well. On board, the currency is Australian dollars. Okay, so very important to kind of highlight that as well. We have our own unique beer called Thirsty Frog, which is served in the Red Frog pub, of course. And we've got some great experiences like that. You can go and sample some of those beers as well. That's one of my favorite beers. It's beautiful. It's delicious.
So I was just going to point out, because you talked about the currency on board the ship is Australian, but when you book it in the US, you would book it in US dollars. You also have the opportunity to book it in Canadian dollars as well if you're in Canada. So it does convert to any of the currencies we currently support. So don't think that you have to pay in Australian dollars until you're on board the ship. Then all charges are in Australian, and their dollar is really weak. So therefore, you feel like a millionaire when you go on board.
I have to mention, this is really important, because the crew members love, and I don't use that word very often, love being on board a ship that's full of Australians and cruising around these places. They absolutely love it. The happiest man on board or lady on board is the bar manager.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Echo that 100%.
I mean, I'm just reading another one. Here's Robert Maines, who's from, he didn't write where he was from, but Robert Maines says, we never thought about taking a cruise out of Australia until our friends persuaded us to go. Never have we had a fun time. Everyone treated you like they were their friend from the old neighborhood. No pretense, no arrogance, just good, good times.
Very good.
Thank you, John. That's fantastic to hear. You know, it's great to hear from our guests and what they hear about. Just what also one thing I just want to highlight as well, our minimum drinking age is different to the US as well, and gambling age is 18. So if you are under 21, and we don't, there's no tipping on board. Of course, we always encourage if you want to tip your room stewards or your waiting staff, they do an absolutely amazing job. Our staff are our backbone of our business. And if you want to recognize them, of course, we always encourage them.
But it's not required there, yes.
And then just one thing, Adolfo, I want to highlight as well. You guys do your group for St. Jude. We have our own children's hospital here in Sydney and one again in Brisbane. We do a wiggle for Westmead and a conga for kids, which is a very similar deck party. So if you are collecting the T-shirts, yes, you can get a wiggle for Westmead and a conga for kids shirt as well. By supporting those two fantastic children's hospitals. So it's all your carnival favourites with like an Aussie kind of flavour and flair. We don't have shrimp, we eat prawns. So you'll see some of the items on the menu a little bit different as well. So keep that in mind.
And it's rocket, not arugula, like in the UK? So I was just going to, on the booking process, if you all remember, prior to, I think it was May when we launched the GoCCL Navigator system in for our Australia product. Prior to that, I don't know how those guys booked their Australian cruises, John, because it was so difficult for a US agent to book it. They had to jump through hoops. So we didn't have a lot of Americans on board, but it's great to hear that we did have some on board. And now when we made the change, moving the Carnival Spirit and Carnival Splendor off of Polar, we actually moved them into GoCCL Navigator. So now you can book everything that Carnival offers in one system. And it's booking, like you book it just like you would book any other Carnival cruise, whether you're booking ship out of Miami on a 4-day cruise to Freeport and Nassau, or you're booking a 14-day back-to-back cruise in Australia. It's really simple to find the destinations in the GoCCL Navigator filter here, where you can filter out all the destinations you want. So you can see Asia, Australia, Papua New Guinea, South Pacific, and New Zealand. So we've made it really simple for you. So now there's really no excuse for you not to be booking a Carnival cruise out of Australia. And then this is just some sample. Like as I said, when you're in the US, you book it in US dollars. When you're in Canada, it would be in Canadian dollars. In the UK, you can book it in pounds. And other European locations, you can book in euros. So we've made it as simple as possible. And then this slide, Mark.
Look, I just want to just really quickly highlight at the end, Adolfo, Australia is very much known for its red center as well. So what you mentioned before about increasing the file size and adding a few extra things as well, if they are just coming, maybe doing a 7-day cruise, a little bit of a stop in Brisbane, don't forget you can add in the red center, and that's the famous Uluru, okay? So Uluru, which is one of the rocks.
I know there's a pic, this one.
That's an iconic Australian photo right there of our kangaroo, jumping in the sunset. And then the following photo is another one of mine as well, which is Uluru, known as Rock. And it is absolutely magnificent. 3/4 of that bad boy is underground. So you just see the top 1/3 of the rock. You can see how big it is, but it's a really neat experience to go out there and it's a short little kind of a couple hour flight, and you're across to from Brisbane or Sydney, and you cross into Uluru, and you can add that to your guests' experience and just kind of really enhance that kind of end experience for them. And maybe sell it as coast to the Red Centre, because that's kind of worked really well.
And that's another iconic photograph that Americans can relate to as well. So, all right. So we were talking a little bit about this with the commission opportunities, and as I said, don't pigeonhole Carnival into 3-4-7-day Caribbean out of a home port in the U.S. we do offer exotic itineraries, Australia being probably the most exotic with the South Pacific. And you can see how either you can book back-to-back cruises because people who are going to Australia are going to want to spend more time on their vacation than they normally would, or I should say holiday. even doing land with a short cruise or land with a 7-day cruise really starts adding up your opportunities to make some additional commission. And, you know, think about people who have been to Europe on Carnival, people who have been to South America, or, you know, they've done Hawaii or Alaska, these more exotic itineraries. Those are the people that you can target and really, you know, find a subset of the guests that you typically book on Carnival that are willing to do these much longer and more exotic itineraries. So we had a few questions that we got ahead of time. When will fly to fund airfare be available from the US to Australia? Right now, we don't have that available, but of course, we're always looking into ways to expand that program. So once we have anything new to share, we'll absolutely share it. How much room do the staterooms have? Are they, you know, some bigger, some larger? Well, obviously, these are two Carnival ships that have been in the US, so you've had an opportunity to be on those. It offers the wide variety of staterooms from inside. Some of them have uppers and lowers, all the way up to the you know, grand suites and all the balcony staterooms. The Carnival Spirit out of Brisbane has about, if I'm not mistaken, 60 or 70% of the ship is balconies, a lot of balcony, very few inside and very few just ocean view. So a big chunk of the ship is balcony. Will you have late night port stays? So Mark, I'm pretty sure I saw on one of the itineraries that we did have some late night or even overnight stays. Am I right? Or did I make that
up? Yeah, that's correct. And look, pretty much the only one for us is Cairns, where we can overnight in Cairns. So generally, majority of our itineraries, whether they be South Pacific or Australia, we generally depart in about 4 o'clock in the afternoon. So that's pretty much a normal time that we'll generally leave the ports by.
Yeah. All right. And then the last question that we have on here is, can you explain Cheers package options and prices? Can you buy it in advance? Very excited. Oh, this one already booked a back-to-back cruise. So exactly what we're talking about. So the Cheers package is available on board the ships in Australia. John, were you going to say something?
No, carry on. Sorry. Oh. I was just saying.
No, it's okay.
Great. It's great to see back to back. That's exactly what I would do.
Yeah.
Exactly. I think that's the way to go. That should be the underlying thing there, because all of our guests, as you said, who've done a Baltic cruise or a transatlantic plus the first cruise in Europe, they love the long on board. So that's exactly what it should be. Sorry, carry on.
No, that's okay. So we do offer the Cheers program in Australia on board the ships. Right now, we don't have the ability for you to pre-book it like you can for the US ships. We are working on that technology, so you have access to the Bon Voyage system as well as Cheers. Cheers is more expensive in Australia. I forgot what the price was, Mark. Can you kind of tell us what that is? Tell them in US dollars, not Australia, because you'll really scare them.
I think it's about 80, 75, 80 US in the US dollars, roughly.
Yeah, so it is more expensive. Part of the reason is because Australians drink a lot. So we weren't losing money on this venture.
Yeah, but it's $119 a day Australian. So that's pretty good if you put it into US.
Yeah. So the last thing we're doing is we're giving away a balcony stateroom on a 7-day cruise from Brisbane, and we have our lucky winner. You're going to send us your information at the email that's on this slide, salescom@carnival.com. And the lucky winner, hopefully you're still here, is Wanda Hamby. Wanda Hamby, who are the winner of a 7-day Australia cruise only in a balcony stateroom on the Carnival Spirit. And we look forward to welcoming you on board. I'm sure Mark will be happy to greet you at the airport and take you around his hometown when you arrive.
Wanda, my goodness, how lucky you are. And you didn't yawn once, which is why you've won.
Yes. So we're at the end of our hour here. It's 3:59, and I just wanted to say a very big thank you to Mark for giving us all his insight and passion about his hometown, Brisbane, and all the great offers that we have. And then, John.
I was not to see a huge spider walk up Mark's wall as he was talking to us.
A big tarantula.
I wanted to see a mass. I thought you all have them in your house, Mark.
Oh, we do. We've got a lot of spiders here. And I'm petrified of spiders. I don't like them. So we've also got like seven, some of the very interesting snakes as well. But it's interesting animals here we have.
Oh, wow.
All right, thanks to all the viewers today. I really appreciate it. We are very honored that you joined us today. And, you know, obviously education is one of the most important things in your business, and learning as much as you can about the destinations, the products that we offer, makes you even a better Carnival expert. So thanks again for joining the very first From Adolfo's Desk Live. And with that, I say cheers. That applies in both countries there.
Bonza.
Hooray.
Have a bonza. River.
Hi.
Bye, everybody.
See you guys.
Bye. River. Bonza.